I'm Dave Lauzun. I'm the vehicle development manager on the Avenger project. You're putting a lot of heart and soul into this vehicle. It's great to finally show it off to the press and the public. So if you can help move over this way, we're going to talk about the engines first here. The engines, many consider the heart of the vehicle. So we're going to talk about the three hearts we have on this vehicle, three engines we offer. Before I get into the details of the engine, I'm going to give you a little bit of an introductory on fuel economy. I know most of you are probably aware of this, but for the 08 model year, the government has changed how they measure fuel economy. They basically applied a mathematical formula to the old fuel economy numbers and downgraded everyone's fuel economy to help better represent real-world customer driving. Now, a few months from now, this will all be commonplace. We'll all be used to the new standards. I'm bringing it up now because the 08 Avenger is one of the first 08 models out there. So being an early 08 model, we'll be out there compared to a lot of other 07 models. So I want to be a little bit careful about comparing 07 numbers and 08 numbers. You may notice in your press kit, we actually put both numbers in there, and I'm going to help discuss both as well. As an example, as you folks I'm sure are very aware, this is the stable mate of the Chrysler Sebring, and the same fuel economy numbers we're getting on the Sebring we get on this vehicle. It's just now we have to report 08 numbers as well for this vehicle. It'll happen to everyone within a few months, but we're hitting it early. All right, let me talk about our 2.4 liter world engine first. Very proud of what this engine is doing for us. This is offered in the Avenger SE and the SXT as standard. This provides best-in-class 173 horsepower, 166 foot-pounds of torque. Now under the 07 model year fuel economy standards, this got 24 miles per gallon city and 32 highway. Under the new 08 standards, it's now, 24 is now 21 city, 30 highway. So you see the shift in the fuel economy numbers, and it varies a little bit from engine to engine. So let me move on now next to our 2.7 liter engine. This is our first available V6. We have another V6 we'll talk about in a minute. But our 2.7 liter engine is available as optional on the SXT. Now this is providing 189 horsepower, 191 foot-pounds of torque, and using the 07 model year numbers, this gets 22 city, 30 miles per gallon highway. When you go to the 08 standards, it's 19 miles per gallon city and 27 miles per gallon highway. Again, a shift there. This is also our flex fuel engine. This can run on up to 85% ethanol or E85, as we're all used to seeing it in the press here. So we've offered the flex fuel on our SXT. And last but certainly not least, is our 3.5 liter V6 engine. And this engine, when combined with our new 6-speed transmission, really provides 0 to 60 times that rival the best in class. We encourage you to drive it yourself. You folks always get better numbers than we do. So we encourage you to do your own testing on 0 to 60 times. This engine is producing 235 horsepower and 232 foot-pounds of torque. And as far as fuel economy, under the 07 standards, it gets 18 miles per gallon city, 28 highway. With the new 08 standards, it's 16 city, 26 highway. So again, the shift there. But we're proud of the lineup of the engines here. All three provide something. Good fuel economy, good performance, good torque to the user. Good lineup of engines. Give the 3.5 a good try today. I think you'll find it's very fun and very aggressive out there. Now, let me move on next to more of the guts of this vehicle. We've taken an Avenger, cut it apart for you, stood it on its side to show you more of the features of the Avenger. And I'm going to use this to talk a little bit about safety, structure, ride and handling, a few things on this. Now, first thing you may notice here, some of you may notice this large shaft running from front to rear. This is the first time we are unveiling that, yes, the Dodge Avenger has all-wheel drive. It is a little bit late availability, be offered in the second quarter of this year. But we're providing all-wheel drive in this Avenger to keep in the Dodge theme of very aggressive and capable driving. And this is a very nice all-wheel drive system. It's you folks drove the Jeeps yesterday. It has many similarities to the Jeep, though a lot of increased torque capacity to handle the increased weight and torque of the Avenger with this 3.5 engine. Very similar system. It's a completely on-demand all-wheel drive system. It responds to driver's throttle input and monitors the wheel speed sensors So it actually anticipates slip in the vehicle and drives torque to the correct wheels before you even get slip. If you do get wheel slip, it also senses that and shifts torque to the vehicle as well. It's all controlled by our electronically controlled coupling, which is attached to the rear differential. And that electronic controlled coupling really senses driving conditions. A couple examples, when you get this out on the road, and by the way, we don't have any all-wheel drives for you today. We've got the RTs, but the all-wheel drives will be showing those, I believe, at the What's New event in Chelsea, so we'll have some of those available. But when you really punch on this vehicle, it'll give you about a 50-50 split between front and rear. If you're cruising on the highway, it's set up to be more of a 95% front, 5% rear. And if you're slipping on ice, like if the front wheels are slipping on ice, it can send up to 60% of the traction to the rear wheels to help get you out of a dangerous situation. When you do get a chance to drive this, you'll find that it's also enhanced the handling of the vehicle. When you have all-wheel drive, you can really mend that beautifully with the ESP traction control system to have it enhance the driving experience as well. So as you're going around tight turns, accelerating, you can actually send torque to the rear wheels so the front tires, more of the tire patch can be engaged in steering the vehicle. So you've got more force for the steering in the front while the rear is helping to do some of the acceleration. So it helps with the driving behavior as well. It's a very fun to drive package. So we're finally glad we have a chance to finally introduce our all-wheel drive package. And this, by the way, is a model. There's actually four models on the Avenger. The Avenger SE, the Avenger SXT, the Avenger RT, and the RT all-wheel drive. So we set that up as a separate model. I'm going to use this buck to talk a little bit about the structure of the vehicle. Not a lot of the body is here, but you can see some of it. But we're very proud of the body on this vehicle. I really view the body as the foundation for a good vehicle. If you design a strong, rigid body, it makes everything else easy. It makes it easier to do the right NVH enhancements to the vehicle. It makes it much easier to tune it dynamically for good ride and handling. And it, of course, it provides that great structural safety cage for good impact performance. So on this body, we have about 30% advanced steels on the body. And that's about as high a percent as we've seen listed out there for other vehicles. It has a mixture of high-strength steels, ultra-high-strength steels, dual-phase steels, and hot stamp steels. So all selected with the careful balance of looking at where we want to reduce weight, increase torsion, increase bending, or add rigidity for impact. In fact, this vehicle is about 1.7 times stiffer than the predecessor vehicle in torsion, 1.6 times stiffer in bending. So much stiffer vehicle. When you get this out on the course today, take it into the tight turns, you'll notice the body stiffness there compared to some of the old models. So it's a good blend in the body. I'm gonna use this to also talk a bit about the chassis on the vehicle. We have a four-wheel independent suspension here. McPherson struts in the front, a multi-link rear suspension. We have a fully isolated front and rear suspension, isolated with rubber isolators to help maintain better road isolation. I think you'll notice that on the road as well. The road isolation, the road noise is quite good on this vehicle. We offer basically two different suspension levels on this. The SE and the SXT models have a suspension system that we believe is actually beautifully tuned for a nice balance between ride and handling. That's more the family car. It has a very nice balance of good, comfortable ride, and yet still sporty enough handling that it feels sure, safe, and confident on the road. You can push the SEs and SXTs hard on the road well. They'll behave quite well for you as well. But then, of course, we've got the RT. You saw the bold, aggressive styling cues we put into the RT and the bold 3.5 engine we put into it. We had to have a suspension that goes along with that RT as well. So we stiffened up the springs, stiffened the shocks, put in a performance tuning in the steering system, a little bit of changes in the bushings to give the RT that sport suspension that it really deserves. So you'll of course feel on the road that the RT is a little more harsh. It's got that sport suspension, a little more harsh as you'd expect. It really absorbs the curves beautifully. Push this one hard in the curves and see what you think of how it behaves. It's a nice suspension system. I'm gonna also talk a bit about the safety features of the vehicle. We have a lot of standard safety features. We've counted over 30. We have, of course, standard dual stage front airbags, standard side curtain airbags, cover the whole front and second row, standard seat mounted airbags, We have a nice package available with, we offer ESP, trash control, brake assist as a package, and those combined really enhance the performance of the vehicle. So very nice safety package on this vehicle as well. And lastly, let me talk a little bit more about features. Ryan already discussed some of the features in the vehicle. I'm going to go into a little more detail on some of them, because we're very proud from an engineering standpoint on how these features have come across here. First one I'll mention again is the heated cool cup holder. I had a lot of questions yesterday on how you're pumping refrigerant through that cup holder system. It's not a refrigerant that's used in there. It's really ceramic tiles with electric current running through them. That you run the current one way, it heats. Run the current another way, it cools. And it'll heat to 140 degrees. So if you've got a hot coffee today, put it in that cup holder, turn it to red. It'll keep your hot coffee hot. We actually tested and we met with people at Starbucks and other places to find out what is the optimal temperature to keep coffee at, and 140 was about the right temperature to keep coffee. If you've got a pop or a water today, put it in there and push the blue button. It'll keep it down to about 35 degrees Fahrenheit, which is, again, nice drinking temperature. This is one of those features that we're glad it's provided a lot of nice publicity out there, but it's by far not a gimmick. It is not just a publicity grab. It is a feature that really works. When you live with this feature for a while, you'll never want to be without it. It's that good. Very, very nice feature. Ryan also showed you our beautiful seats, but let me talk about some of the functions of our seats. We're also very proud of the Yes Essentials seating surfaces. You may have heard about our Yes Essentials by now. We've tried almost everything on these seats to stay in them. It has a anti-static, antimicrobial, antifungal property built right into the fabric. And we tried chili dogs, we tried ketchup, we tried mustard, we poured red wine on these seats, and we cannot get these seats to stain. So, I know I encourage you to try the heated cool cup holders today. I don't necessarily encourage you to try pouring stuff on your seats before we drive. You will hold us up, they will clean up, but it'll take a couple hours to get them all dry and such. But they clean up beautifully, you'll never know that the wine stains were there. Nice, nice feature of the seats. We also offer heated cloth seats. Heated leather is always very common. Heated cloth is much less common. I've always been a fan of leather in the past because I liked having the heated seats and I liked having the cleanability of leather. Well, now when you've got the Yes Essentials seating surfaces for cloth and you've got heated cloth seats available, really it's taken away the two biggest disadvantages of cloth seats. So cloth, I think, will become more popular now when you've taken away some of the disadvantages. And lastly, I want to talk a bit about the MyGig system a little bit more. It is our all-new infotainment navigation system. It has a 20 gig hard drive in it. You can take CDs, rip your CDs right into the hard drive. It'll store about 1,600 songs, which is about 100 hours of music. So you could drive coast to coast and back again, not listen to the same song twice with this system. You can store your own photos onto the system. You can take some of the Sebring photos and the Avenger photos we've given you today, load those right into the vehicle and store photos right there. Store your own family photos. It has a very nice DVD and navigation system. The navigation system has both 2D and 3D views of the road. It has voice activation, and it even has real-time traffic when combined with satellite radio. So a lot of nice features built into this MyGig navigation auto and infotainment system. So with that, I'm delighted to finally show you some of the guts of the insides of this vehicle, all the things beneath all this beauty. We'll turn it back over to Tom to talk more about pricing.